Welcome, I'm Lisa Davis, the host of Publishing Connections, and we're here today with Darryl Green. He's an author and publisher of several books. Darryl's here today to help us learn how to publish books effectively. Welcome, Darryl.
Hello, Lisa. How you doing?
Good, good, very good. And so nice of you to be here. Darryl, we're here today to talk about the problems that exist in publishing. So tell us, why do so many authors have problems with publishing their work?
Well, firstly, I'm just glad to be here. So many times authors come to me and ask, how can I become published? And when they become published, they find out that they're not successful. And one of the problems that most authors face is that they don't understand the publishing process. And to be honest with you, publishing is about making money. It's about making businesses. And unfortunately, most publishers don't make a lot of money. And so, through trial and error, authors finally learn that it's a business before it, and it's too late. And so what I try to do is I try to give them a process in understanding how to successfully market their book. And I've worked with hundreds of individuals in terms of teaching seminars, teaching workshops, trying to give them a simple, logical process of being successful. And that's hopefully what we'll do today.
Tell me, why do so many authors have so many problems getting their work published?
Lisa, that's a great, great question. I think it starts with the initial reason why you publish a book. And I wrote a special report, I wrote an e-book on publishing professionals, individuals. And they have a purpose. There's a difference between publishing a fiction book versus publishing a nonfiction book. So it starts with, what is the reason you're publishing your book? You know, are you trying to get famous? A lot of times I hear people say, Darryl, I want to get on Oprah. I want to be famous. I want to drive that BMW. I want to be the best. And a lot of times I tell them there's a strategy for your madness. So it starts basically is, why do you want to write the book? And we build from that. You start with your goal, and then you build on the strategies. But most times when I'm talking with authors, they do not really know why they want to get a book. I just want to do it because it feels good. And so I tell them that basically you could publish a book, go to Kinko's, do it yourself, and sell it to grandmama and grandpapa. And you don't need to go any further. But if you're really serious about learning how to be successful in the commercial publishing world, then there's a strategy, there's a process. If you go to the grocery store and you don't prepare, you'll buy anything. But if you prepare, then maybe you won't go broke.
But it's focused on, why are you writing a book? Why are you writing a book? And it depends. If you only write one book, you say, well, I want to write a book because I want everybody to know that I wrote a book. You can just do one book. Now, if you do one book, it's going to cost you a lot of money, $100 maybe, to write a book. But guess what? You've gained credibility. You say, I want to have a bestseller. Well, you're looking at over $100,000 because you got to put your marketing in. So it depends on what you want.
You mentioned that there's a big difference between publishing fiction and nonfiction. Can you give us an idea of what some of the differences would be?
Clearly, there's a distinction between fiction and nonfiction because you're dealing with a market. The market is very different. For example, a person who writes poetry. Poetry is a niche. There are only certain people that like poetry. Whereas if you look at in the nonfiction industry, where 90% of the books that are published are fiction or nonfiction, there's a greater market because people want information. We live in an information age. And so when you're talking about publishing fiction, it's very tough. And for most authors, it's a trial and error process. And so what I've been trying to do with my new e-book, Book Publishing for Professionals, is lining out a process for them. And the process may work for fiction, but it's highly specialized because you have to find the right kind of market. It takes a lot more time and a lot of detail. So what I try to do right now is work with people who are interested in nonfiction because the process is a lot different and I can help them better.
Speaking of reality and marketing your book, what is a realistic goal?
It starts with understanding the reason why you're writing a book. I mentioned you could do it yourself, go to Kinko's and sell it to your grandmother or grandfather. But you have to understand in terms of the market that you're interested in going into and looking at those publishers, doing your homework. You know, you're gonna take your time when you're buying a car. You're supposed to be very diligent in trying to find that right car and the right dealership. In the same way, when you're dealing with a publisher, you need to understand what kind of genre, or we call the categories of books that that person publishes. You also need to know, if you're dealing with a major publisher, you have to understand that most major publishers, they're not interested in us, you know, in terms of Joe Blow public. They want, like, Dennis Rodman, Paris Hilton, because they're established people. And so that's one of the reasons you have to think, do you want a small publisher? Do you want a large publisher? Do you want to self-publish, which is, by the wave of the future right now, in terms of forecasting, or we call foresight. Those are the type of things that are happening. So it boils down again, why do you want to write the book? And what are your desired outcomes? What most individuals really don't get into. They really don't think about that until they're already into the process, and they've had very little success in publishing the book. And so in terms of what we're doing today, basically is we assume that the person has the book published, and right now they're struggling to try to figure out, how do I become more successful in the publishing world? Whether they go with a major publisher or whether they're self-publishing, the process that I provide is pretty much the same.
Self-publishing, you have all control. I mentioned about books being a book, that the publishing industry is a money-making industry. That when you go with a big publisher, guess what? You have very little control. They design your book for you. They say, well, we don't like what's in the content. You need to change it around so to sell, because it's about getting your book sold. And so that's one of the problems that you have. But when you self-publish it, you take all the profit, and you take all the risk, which is good about that.
How does one compete in the market when there are so many publishers?
You published a book. You told me you were going to publish a book.
I am publishing a book on consulting.
Okay. Now you have your idea, you have your objectives. It starts basically from what I would say from your goal. What would be your goal? Do you want fame? Do you want fortune? Do you want to be on Oprah Winfrey?
Okay,
or is it personal fulfillment?
For those out there who want to be on Oprah Winfrey, why don't we talk about that?
Oh, no, not the Oprah Winfrey question.
So many of my writers have written in and asked, if I write a book, how would I get on Oprah Winfrey? Is that a realistic goal?
I normally give my clients and my students, in marketing, there's a term we call marketing mix. And what I do is focus on that marketing mix, which is the product of your book. Your book is your product. Books are a product.
Okay.
I know most people don't like that, but books are a product. You focus on your product. You focus on the price. You focus on what we call placement or distribution channel, and you focus on promotion. Those are the key areas you try to take in mind. Then it goes to the standpoint of, who are the people going to read your book? It goes, we call that your target audience. Who is your target audience and who's your target market? In that case, I believe that authors should have a very intimate relationship with their constituencies, or what I call your target market. So with me, I normally write nonfiction. And so I'm trying to, whether it's dealing with single parents or working couples, trying to understand what are their issues. And one of the key things is I try to fix a problem. Is there a problem in the marketplace that we can fix and that we can repair? And that's what I try to market on. That's why I try to encourage the individuals that write nonfiction answer a problem. And it goes back to being what we call a servant leader. Fulfilling a problem, helping somebody out, and in that way you gain more influence. So it's also about you helping them, and in that way, in terms of marketplace, repays you by in terms of your book becoming successful.